What's going on YouTube? Today's video, I'm gonna be installing stack leather on this queue. Before I install the stack leather on this queue, I wanna thank Ryan, the builder and owner of Rats Queue, for posting a video on Facebook on how to install stack leather. I'm gonna be installing stack leather on this old Viking queue. This is one of my first queues. I have some scratches, so I'm gonna be getting rid of that. I'm gonna do my best. I'm gonna put a CA coat on it, refurbish the whole queue. Before I put the leather on, let's go ahead and weigh the queue to know exactly how much the queue weighs. This has no weight at all. As you can see, it weighs 13.05 ounces. To install the stack leather, I ordered a tan leather from Queue Components, a burnisher, liquid burnisher, and I'm gonna be using some alcohol, a crafting tool, of course your tape, an acid brush. This is what I'm gonna put the glue on, and the glue what I'm gonna be using is Elmer's all-purpose glue. It's just a white glue. The sandpaper, 100, 150, and 220. To polish it, I'm gonna be using Pledge and some Queue Wax. And I'm gonna be using, of course, a straight edge and a cutting board. And this is the lathe I'm gonna be using to install the stack leather. Well, here's the finished product on the stack leather on the Viking Q. As you can see, this is what I did. This is the stack leather. I re-dyed the leather itself to make it a richer brown on itself. I also sanded this part of the Q and I had to restain that. This is actually espresso on the stain. Try to match it with the original itself. And having it all CA'd the whole Q, it makes it feel like a full wrapless Q. Hopefully this video was informative. If you haven't already, hit that subscribe button. Also, leave a comment down below, hit the like button, and thank you for watching, and see you next time. I wasn't satisfied with the result of the Q, how it turned out, so I'm gonna redo the Q again. So I put it on the lay. As you can see, I already started sanding it. This is what it is. I actually use this Black & Decker mouse sander. It actually oscillates and it prevents it from gumming up, which is actually a lot better and takes a lot. It's a lot smoother, as you can see, when it comes out. So I'm not wasting all the sandpaper. Also, for dyeing the leather, this is what I used, the leather dye. And this is what I used to actually stain the wood. So I got some spots, so I'm gonna be staining also some spots of the wood using this. And once I finish sanding the leather, I'm gonna be using this leather dye. So here's the finished product again. As you can see, this is how the stack leather turned out. This is with the CA. It goes all the way through. And I, of course, I polished it to make it all nice and shiny. It's pretty much refurbishing the queue. What I didn't like when I finished the queue before, the leather was really thick. So I could feel the transition between the queue and the stacked leather, and it was really thick. But now it's pretty much a better transition. So also, I didn't weigh the final queue. So if you notice, I got the scale out, and the final weight of the queue itself is going to be 14.10 ounce. So it added about an ounce, but remember, I had no wrap on this queue, and this is my old wrap for my Predator. As you can see, it weighs 0.85 ounces. So it added about an ounce of the leather and the CA itself for the total queue. And hopefully this video was informative. If you haven't already, hit that subscribe button. Also, leave a comment down below and hit that like button. Thank you for watching and see you next time.
Thank you for watching. Please subscribe me. Don't forget the thumbs up. Bye bye.